There's no doubt wireless has grown a lot until present date, with a lot of users using mobile phones to access internet and watch video platforms like YouTube and TikTok via their mobile phones every second. Even most of our houses are incorporated with Internet of Things via our Wi-Fi service. We can now play online games, stream videos, record our surveillance cameras all at once due to the evolution of wireless. 802.11 standards has evolved from 802.11a and b standard to now having 802.11ax or Wi-Fi 6, which behaves similar to a wired network. There is no doubt wireless is here to stay. On our last lesson, our router was able to access the internet, but our clients were not able to access the internet. And we said we're going to answer why our clients are not able to access the internet on this lesson. Welcome to Technology for All Academy, an academy that teaches information communication technology for free. To mention but a few, we have Cisco and Microtik series, and we'll be doing other vendor series in the future. For those who don't know me, my name is Thabang Makobe, the founder of Technology for All Academy. In this lesson, we'll be learning how to do the Wi-Fi configuration and also the network address translation configuration. So I have already opened my Winbox. I'm going to start by configuring our wireless access point so that it can be able to give service to our clients. So in order to do that, I'm going to start first by enabling our wireless interface because it is disabled by default. So we can go to interface, click on wireless LAN 1, then click on the right arrow in order to enable it. So let me disable it. The other way that we can also enable it, we can go to our wireless, click on Wi-Fi interface, click on wireless 1, and then click on the right arrow to enable it. The first thing that I'm going to start with is to configure our security profile. On the top tabs, I'm going to click on security profile tab and then click the addition sign. We'll give name to our security profile. I'm gonna name it lab test, and then the mode, gonna make it dynamic keys. And for authentication, I'm going to choose WPA2 with PSK. And our password, let's make it 12345678. We need eight characters for the password. Then click OK. Then we go to Wi-Fi interface. Double click on our wireless LAN 1. For mode, let's click on the drop down arrow. There are a lot of modes in there, but for all of these modes, we will learn them on the future lessons. For now, we're just gonna do the access point bridge. We're gonna select the access point bridge. Access point bridge meaning it will be point to multipoint, meaning our wireless access point will be giving service to our clients. If we choose maybe bridge or something, then it won't be point to multipoint. So that in order for our wireless access point to give service to our clients, we have to choose AP bridge. The band, we're gonna leave the band as they are, BGN. Channel width, gonna leave it as it is. Frequency, let's click the drop down arrow. As you can see, there are lots of frequencies there, but I'm going to use auto. But the thing that I wanted to show you is that you can click on your frequency usage tab, and then in order to see the other wireless clients that are in your area, which frequency are they using, you click start. And then as you can see in my area right now, 2.412 2.417, 2.422, 2.427, 2.457. As you can see, there's some movement that's happening there. And you can see some of the frequencies, there's nothing happening. So you can do the frequency usage test, and then from there you'll be able to see what's happening in your area and you'll choose a clean channel. But for me on this lesson, I'm just gonna leave it as auto. And our SSID, let's change our SSID to lab Wi-Fi. Lab Wi-Fi. And on wireless protocols here, let's click the drop down arrow. As you can see, it's 802.11. And then from InStream going down, those are proprietary standards for MikroTik. But on this lesson, I'm going to leave it as any. More on those on the upcoming lessons in the future. So I'm going to leave it as any. And security profile, I'm gonna choose the security profile that we created, which is lab test, and click OK. And with that, we are done configuring our wireless access point. So now what we are going to do, we're gonna configure network address translation so that our clients can be able to go to the internet. And to do that, we go to IP. But before we can configure our net, let's see if our clients are still not able to access the internet. Let's go to command prompt, and then let's see if our DNS first is working. We'll ping google.com, ping google.com. We want to see if we have internet and DNS is working. Ping request, could not find host google.com. Please check the name and try again. As you can see, our DNS is not going any far. Then let's ping 8.8.8.8, which is DNS server for Google. And let's see, request timeout. So meaning we still don't have internet to our clients. Our clients are still not able to access the internet. So let's press Control C. And then I'll minimize my command prompt because I'm still gonna use it again. So in order to configure network address translation, we go to IP, firewall. On the top tabs, we click on net tab. Then we click the addition sign. On general, let's go to general. Chain, we leave it as source net. Source address, make it 10.10.10.0/24. Which is our network and our subnet mask, which is 255.255.255.0. And then on the top tabs, we click on action tab. And then for action, let's click the drop down arrow and choose masquerade. Masquerade is the command that let us do network address translation on MikroTik. Then we click OK. And then by this, we are done configuring our net. Our clients by now can be able to go to the internet. But before anything else, let's go to our command prompt. And then I'll give the command ipconfig to see if we got the IP address /O. And as you can see, we got the address 10.10.10.255. And then let me ping 8.8.8.8, enter. As we can see, we are able to access the internet right now. And then ping google.com, enter. And google.com, our DNS is working. We can find google.com. And then right now, let me see if I can connect to the internet with my phone. Yes. I'm connected to lab Wi-Fi. Let's see if I go to IP DHCP server and then let's go to list. Yes, as we can see, there's the address that we saw for our PC, which is 10.10.10.254, And then 10.10.10.253 is the address that my phone got from the DHCP server. So our Wi-Fi is also working. And with that, this brings us to the end of this lesson. Hope you found this lesson informative. And if you did, please share with someone you think will also benefit from this video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button so that you can be notified whenever we drop a video or a lesson. Let me love and leave you.